Did you know, at present, 129 billion face masks are used and disposed every month globally? That is 3 million a minute. The ongoing COVID-19 pandemic has driven massive consumption of personal protective equipment worldwide. Unfortunately, this sudden pandemic has barely allowed us enough time to manage and recycle disposable masks in a proper way. And due to this, a huge amount of PPE waste is being generated, with little to no management. In Bangladesh, 3.4 billion masks are being used and disposed every month, and in the city of Dhaka, 0.19 million tons of face mask waste is being generated daily, an estimated 80% of which is entering the marine and ocean. This is causing serious pollution and endangering aquatic life, as well as causing waterlogging in Dhaka, rendering life conditions abysmal, particularly during monsoon. However, this doesn't have to be a problem with no solution. This waste can be used as a resource as well. How? We provided a solution here. Personal protective equipment such as face masks are mostly composed of plastic polymers. Polypropylene is its main component, along with other polymers such as polyethylene, polystyrene, polycarbonate and many more, which in landfill can take more than 25 years to break down. Our team explores an innovative way to use pandemic waste in concrete construction, which is by incorporating these plastic waste as cementitious material, composing a type of polypropylene fiber reinforced concrete, or FRC. Now, what is FRC? Fiber reinforced concrete is a composite material consisting of fibrous material which increases its structural integrity. It includes mixture of cement, mortar, or concrete with uniformly dispersed suitable fibers.
Now let us discuss the composition of this polypropylene fiber reinforced concrete. An advanced recycling process has been adapted in which medical wastes were processed at elevated temperature and pressure into the shape of fibers and subsequently added into a concrete mixture. The applied dosage was 1 mask per 1 liter of concrete, which equals the addition of 2 kg of processed material per 1 cubic meter of a mixture. The treatment of the masks with elevated temperature and pressure leads to the formation of homogeneous polypropylene. The recycling procedure provided complete disinfection of used mask and potentially enabled one to modify the selected properties of a final product. The final polypropylene fibers were investigated using a vast range of experimental methods, that is, Fourier transform infrared spectroscopy, thermogravimetric analysis, surface free energy, and contact angle measurement and rheology. The performed experiments, which are in compliance with ASTM codes, delivered information considering the composition of the product material, the melting temperature, and the properties of the surface, which influenced the polypropylene cement paste interaction during hardening. The experimental analysis of the newly developed concrete was focused not only on basic mechanical properties of the material, but also on its transport properties and its stability in an aggressive environment. It was revealed that the addition of PPE mask has various influence on different properties. For example, it increased the compressive strength and simultaneously slightly deteriorated tensile strength or capillary absorption. The applied technology allows to improve the recycling capacity of the medical wastes. 1 meter cube of concrete would consume 1,000 masks. The addition of polypropylene fibers to concrete improved its 28-day compressive strength approximately to 5%. So, the proposed solution not only reduces PPE waste, but also betters it. Now let us consider the implementation of this technology in a real-life scenario. Constructions are being demolished and built all time everywhere. Such can also be seen in Kauran Bazar Azimpur area in Dhaka, Bangladesh. Polypropylene-based FRC can be used in this construction site by recycling the huge amount of medical waste in Dhaka. But why just stop there? Waste materials and byproducts such as reclaimed paving materials, past furnace slag, silica fume, fly ash, sawdust, cramped rubbers, street sweepings can be collected from the demolition and construction sites at Kauran Bazar area to utilize them as admixtures in concrete construction. These recycled materials contribute to the reduction of permeability and bleeding, improvement in strength, resistance against sulfate attack, enhanced plastic energy absorption capability, and not to mention manage a significant amount of waste.
This proposed solution shows a great potential for positive impact on our society. The advantages of this polypropylene FRC are: number one, reduces and recycles a massive amount of plastic medical waste by turning it into a resource. Number two, creates an eco-friendly and yet durable concrete. Number three, reduces the cost of concrete production by reusing certain materials. Number 4. Carbon dioxide emission is reduced significantly due to using less amount of cement than the traditional concrete. It also fulfills many of the sustainable development goals, particularly Goal 11, Sustainable Cities and Communities, Goal 12, Responsible Consumption and Production, Goal 13, Climate Action, and Goal 14, Life Below Water. We didn't choose this pandemic. We certainly didn't anticipate the sudden rise of disposable face masks and other forms of personal protective equipment or the colossal waste it is generating. But deal with it, we must. And it is our belief this proposed solution might pave the way by reducing waste, enhancing concrete strength, and thereby promoting sustainability. I would like to end with a quote by Kofi Annan. Our biggest challenge in this new century is to take an idea that seems abstract, sustainable development, and turn it into a reality for all the world's people. Thank you very much.